I mentioned last week, and I must mention again, that I know at that Cubs-Cleveland game, there was a great cloud of witnesses, lifelong Cub fans that are no longer with us, including my grandfather. I had not thought about my grandfather for years, but when the Cubs made the World Series, he was suddenly present with me again. That's the beauty of memory, my friends. That's the beauty where you're reminded of the legacy that has been left you by those who have gone before. So today, we are mindful and we remember. I mentioned earlier that we're thinking, remember me as a breath prayer, but you can also remember Grandpa. Remember Cub fans. Remember. In remembering, what we actually do is remember those people back into our community. Because indeed, the love that they shared with us in this life is a love that is without end. It is with that knowledge that we can lay down the people we love, either into the ground or into a columbarium or whatever it may be. And when you lay down, remember them in their new state of being. And also remember that life isn't over, but has begun again. In Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, he reminds us that a lot of things in life will pass away. A lot of things, like our understanding and our limits on our understanding of God, the prophecy that we think we know the future, that's all going to go away. But there is one thing that remains, love. For love is without end. May you watch this next video with love in your heart and be mindful that love is without end. So here we are, living in the meantime. In the meantime, in this life, until we go into the next life, we live and we love and we do our best. So how is it that the people who have touched our lives in some way, who have died, can continue to live on? Well, through the likes of you and me. Because indeed, each moment of love that they shared with you in this life can go on. Have you ever noticed when you're lighting candles that you can light a candle from another one, and this candle loses nothing in order to light this one? We've gone electronic, kids, but that's all right. You lose nothing, but what you do is you make the world a brighter, better place. That's how the love that was shared with you will go on in this world. The love that was shared with you lights your heart. And then you go forth and light someone else's heart and light someone else's heart. That's what we do in the meantime. Today we're going to give you an opportunity to participate in a service of remembrance. To light the candle that was given to you when you came in. If you weren't given one, we have some spare up here. And then just simply remember one or many. We invite you to come down these center aisles and hug the inside of the aisle. And then when you're returning, hug the outside aisle. So I'm calling this the inside, and I'm calling that the outside. These aisles are also available to you if you would like to go through and return to your seats in that direction. But just be mindful. As you come down, be mindful of the light that was shared with you, and then as you share it here, commit yourself to transform the world with the love that was given to you, a love that is without end. You are welcome to come down at your leisure. We have a couple of songs for you to do that with. And as we share in this service, we will be accompanied by heaven. Amazing how God works. I just received news that our newest gardener, a baby girl, was born to Cindy last night. A brand new baby girl who has already been to this service many, many times. What a beautiful reminder of the beautiful cycle of life. That indeed love lives on. Today, we invite you to go forth and share this love and light with each soul you come into contact with until we all go up to that high mountain. Amen.